This seems like it has, I mean, implications for human aging, because, you know, if you're talking about humans as we age, we something occurs called immunosenescence, where we start to lose some of our, you know, we don't make as many lymphocytes. Actually, it's the lymphoid population that decreases with age. And so if you're able to then be able to activate these hematopoietic stem cells to regenerate, you know, the blood cell population, that seems like it would have implications for aging. But also, I thought you found something very interesting in that paper, and that was what we talked about with the regenerating the hematopoietic stem cells, which also increased in cell number, if I remember correctly. You also did this experiment in older mice, and you showed something very interesting, I thought, because as we age, the immunosenescence seems to be happening, and I'm doing a huge oversimplification here, but it seems to be happening in the lymphoid cells, which are mostly B and T cells, as opposed to the other blood cells we have, the myeloid lineages, which are composed of neutrophils, macrophages, platelets, things like monocytes. So as we age, we have more of those types of immune cells and less the other. But you actually found that if you fasted those animals, something happened with that populations, correct?
Yeah, so we found that the lymphocytes number goes back to the more youthful level, and the ratio of myeloid cells to lymphocytes goes also back, not to the same level as during youth, but certainly it moves in that direction. And so the profile of the immune system is much more similar to the young one. So essentially, we see rejuvenation of the system.